Hi, I'm David Pereira. Welcome to my channel. In today's episode, I want to talk to you about a massive misunderstanding among many product owners. And this is the question I want to answer. When does the job of a product owner finish? Many people understand that differently, including me, at the beginning of my career. I'd like to start sharing a story with you. When I started my first job as a product owner, I used to think that my role was to ensure we maximize the amount of features delivered. What did I do? Every sprint, I would talk to the stakeholders, understand what they wanted, and stakeholders would pressure me to deliver more and more and more. Then I would go and talk to developers and clarify what could we take for the next interaction. And developers would focus on implementing. And they would always look at me and say,
why are we building this feature for? We never know the problem we're solving. We have a feeling that we are in a vicious circle.
And the truth is, they were right. We were in a vicious circle. Sprint by sprint, I talked to stakeholders, understood what they wanted, and then brought to the developers. Developers found solutions for that problems, and then we implemented. And after this, we showed to the stakeholders. Stakeholders would say, wow, perfect, that's exactly what we want. So let's go to the next cycle. And we lived in this prison for at least 1 year. And what happened? We delivered many features
that nobody needed.
We delivered many things
that nobody needed.
And we solved few problems that existed and still existed after all the features we delivered. Because focusing on the features is a suicide for product owners. Now, I want to ask you, what is value? Do you know what is that? And do you know when does our job as a product owner finish? Let's start with the first misunderstanding. Maximizing story points has nothing to do with maximizing value for the product. When we focus on delivering more story points, for example, the first sprint we deliver 30, and then 33, and 35, and so on, it is pointless. It doesn't matter the amount of story points we deliver. What matters is the value. And once we focus on just maximizing story points, we may focus on the wrong things. We focus on pleasing stakeholders by doing what they want. And when you pressure developers to do more, what happens? Developers will look at you and say,
"Oh, it doesn't matter how hard we work. It's never enough. And when we fail to deliver one specific feature at the end of the sprint, you are mad with us. You want always more and more and more. And that no matter what we do, we will never be able to feed the beast. So what can we do? Can you give us a problem that is worth solving instead of this amount of solutions to implement?"
That is the thing when you focus on maximizing story points. And it's connected to the second point, which is not value, it's about features. I have a feeling that many product owners read a book from Jeff Sutherland, which by the way is a great book, but misunderstand the concept behind it. The book is called The Art of Doing Twice the Work in Half of the Time, or something like this. But product owners understand that as the art of producing double the pointless features in half of the time. And that's what we kept doing, maximizing the features that nobody needed. Is it what being a product owner is supposed to be? I guess not. Product owners are not supposed to maximize features. We are supposed to maximize the value. And one sign that you are focused on maximizing features is the following. Sprint by sprint, you deliver more features and then you start the new cycle. You don't do anything after it. And then another sign is, I'd like to ask you a question. When was the last time you killed a feature? Yes, that's the thing. You should kill features that are distractions for end users. If it doesn't bring value to the end users, you remove it. Because a good product is not the product that has nothing more to add. A good product is a product that has nothing more to remove. Your product should not produce distractions to your end users. Your product should produce ways to achieving your value proposition. And now I come to the point. What is this crazy value? Value is not pleasing stakeholders, is not maximizing user stories, is not delivering more features or maximizing story points at the end of the sprint. Value is change the lives of the users for the better in a way that generate business. For example, once you implement something and you enable customers to do more than they can do now, you deliver value for the customers. And then if that generated something for the business, you maximize the value for the business. If you focus on this, you understand what value is. And the point is, the job of a product owner doesn't finish once you put a feature available for the end user. Feature is no more than a means to an end. The end is never the output. The end is the outcome. You should start with the end in mind. What do you want to achieve? What is the impact you want to generate? And then you have to measure the results. If you are not measuring the results, you are not being a product owner at all. You are not maximizing the value. And you need to find ways of doing that. For example, if you realize that you have a very bad NPS, Net Promoter Score, it means your customers are not satisfied with your product. Then you need to find ways to solving that, to increase your customer satisfaction. No business can survive without engaged customers. If your customers don't care about your product, whenever they find an alternative with the competitor, they will go away. So if your NPS is bad, you have to provide alternatives to solve that. And then you need to measure if your NPS is improving. If your NPS is improving, it means the feature you generated caused the impact that you wanted. If your NPS is standing still, it means that feature didn't deliver any value. You should kill it. Don't be afraid of removing what distracts customers. If it doesn't add value, you remove. You should find ways of changing the business and producing value for the end users. It is never sustainable to focus solely on the business. You cannot produce value for the business if the customer doesn't connect to that. It is sustainable once you generate something for the customer that in return will generate something for the business. And that's what you want to achieve. Don't misunderstand what your job as a product owner is. Don't think that you are responsible for putting more and more features live. Be sure that you are responsible for changing people's lives for the better. That's what you want to do. What's your experience of measuring value? Write down in the comments. And also, if you enjoy this content, don't forget to hit the like button. And if you want to get more similar content, subscribe for more. And thanks for watching.